General Yoweri Museveni sounded the war drums and asked African states to galvanize and sweep the Al-Shabaab off the continent. The president's body language told it all. He was clearly upset.
People who dared to attack African Union flag, whose interests they represent, who do not respect the African Union.
During the opening of the African Union Heads of States meeting at Peak Resort Munyonyo, a tough-talking Museveni also fired a direct salvo at the Middle East, a hotbed of Islamic militancy.
Let us now act in concert and sweep them out of Africa. Let them go back to Asia and the Middle East, where I understand many of them come from.
When the Al-Shabaab struck Kampala on July 11th, they did not know they are signing their own death warrant. African leaders and other world leaders attending the African Union summit here at Munyonyo are reading from the same script, saying the Al-Shabaab must be annihilated. African heads of states and other prominent leaders gathering here amid tight security and heavy military presence joined in condemning the Al-Shabaab and rallied support to defeat the insurgents who have sowed anarchy in war-torn Somalia. This AU summit, perhaps the largest gathering ever since 2002, drew leaders from as far as the Middle East, North America and the Caribbean, underlining a global desire to defeat terrorism. The Palestinian Liberation Organization leader Mahmoud Abbas, Mexican President Felipe Calderon, UN Deputy Secretary General Dr. Asha Mijiro and US Attorney General Eric Holder were in attendance. Earlier, the chairman of AU Heads of States, Malawi President Bingu wa Mutharika, asked the government to observe a two-minute silence for the victims of the Kampala bomb attacks.
Terrorism has no place in Africa. Terrorism has no place in the development of humanity.
The Somalia impasse seems to have overshadowed discussion of the theme of the conference, maternal and child health. The decision to deploy more troops in Somalia got a huge boost recently as troops from Guinea undergoing training in Addis Ababa await a green light to deploy. Djibouti is also likely to deploy soon as the noose continues to tighten against the Al-Qaeda proteges. Imam Taizibwa, NTV Weekend Edition.